The real purpose for which you were preparing is about to start. I feel like someone has been practicing, it's time to perform. I feel like God is about to project you and future you, here is, until the time of his showing forth to Israel. There's a preparation time, there's a projection time. I just have a feeling that you have paid your dues. It's time for life to pay you back. It's time for rewards to begin to come. It's time for the progress that you have been praying about to become your experience. Am I making sense to somebody in the house here? You have been in reserve. It's time for God to bring you out of reserve and to begin to showcase you. Am I talking to somebody in the house here? I believe you are coming to your best season. You have come to a season where, like plant, there was a withering. Leaves fell, but I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. I see something coming for someone here. You are about to evolve in new dimensions, in new places, in new ways. Hear this. Where they were not expecting to see you ever again, as far as they were concerned, like Joseph, they forgot to where they buried you. Now they will bow to you in the name of Jesus. Is somebody feeling me in the house? They forgot you. Someone, they canceled your contract. They decided not to deal with you. As far as they are concerned, they have moved on. But hear this, the last is becoming the first. There's a turnaround coming for someone here. I believe that the spirit of leadership, God is taking you from the tail to be the head in the name of Jesus Christ. Hear this, if you have been dreaming about it or you're not sure, something new is about to happen to you. You will celebrate something new. If you feel me, they'll say loud, amen. Praise the Lord. And we should not forget this. Psalm 100 verse 4 says, enter into his gate with thanksgiving. That's a wonderful verse 1. And it says in verse 4, be thankful unto him. Yesterday, God gave us the understanding that when he establishes relationships and they have not outlived their purposes, whatever brought a separation has lapsed and he is bringing a reconciliation. Can we appreciate him, O Lord, for prophetic solution? Hallelujah. Every of your relationships that have not outlived their purposes, God, we refresh those divine contacts for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you for your impartation and we thank you for reactivation of every divine contact that is still useful to us. Hallelujah. Now, this month, we've been discussing the series on the spirit of leadership. And that is inspired from John chapter 14, verse 6, where the Bible says, or Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And so the question is, you may know what you do, but do you know who you are? Jesus was working miracles. Jesus was teaching. Jesus was doing stuff that made people recognize him. But he also knew, there was a time he called disciples and said, who do men say that I am? You know what I'm saying here? If people are confused about you, you should be convinced about yourself. If people don't know you, you should know who you are. They asked John, are you the Christ? He said, even if it looks as if the Christ is a higher pedestal, he's famous, I am not the Christ. You cannot confuse me because I know. And I'm saying this to someone here. God made two great lights. Somebody said, me two great lights. In Genesis chapter 1, you know what that means? He made the sun and the moon. Even though the moon reflects the sun and comes at night, you should still feel like even though you look small and insignificant, there's greatness inside you. He made the moon also great as the sun. When he created them, people celebrate the sun, but what God created was greatness in both of them. Don't let somebody's fame make you look like a failure. Did you hear what I said? Did I say that to you again? Don't let somebody's fame make you look like a failure. Jesus was famous and they came to John. Are you the Christ? He said, no, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. You know what? If I don't fulfill my ministry, Jesus will be slowed down because he says, I make a highway for the Lord. If he may not celebrate me, but the people who need me will honor me. If John did not prepare the way, the grace that people receive from Christ will have taken a longer time. Maybe he will not have finished his ministry in 3 years. Because he says, I am the voice of one making, crying in the wilderness, make a highway. So someone cleared the path. Jesus went to the baptism of John. As John may not look as significant as Jesus, it was at the baptism of John he received the impartation to start his ministry. Sometimes you may even feel bigger and greater than your boss in the office. But look at me. If he did not start you off, you will not take off. Did I say that to you? Even if you feel bigger, if someone does not start you off, you may never take off. It's like a child who feels better and bigger than the mother. If a womb did not carry you, there will be no voice that people will listen to. So in life, you must recognize not what just you do, but you must know who you are. So Jesus says to them, I am the way, the truth, the life. I don't just work miracles. If you want to cross to the realm of the spirit, you want to get promoted, you want to change your business, if you don't recognize me, I am the way through which you can ascend and come through to the Father. Don't despise those who are on your path because they can close the door to your future. I think if we end the service, somebody is blessed already. You must understand how the spirit of leadership works. And how does it work? You must think and act, not like a leader, as a leader. Because from the time God created man, even before God created man, before, somebody said with me before, before God created man, he blessed him. It says in Genesis 1:26, let us make man. That was a proposition. Then he went into action. That's the Trinity. I want us to please take note of that. When he says, let us make man in our image, in our likeness, it was a collaborative effort. The whole world, you and I, started with cooperation. The Spirit moved. God spoke. Collaborative work. And that's leadership. Leadership basically means you involve others in what you do. Somebody said me, others. If you do it alone, you don't last. Jesus had the anointing. He went to the street to go and look for people who will receive the Spirit from him. And after he was leaving, he gave them the same charge. You will receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Then you cannot stop the flow. Somebody said me, the flow. You must become witnesses or spread this anointing in Jerusalem, in Judea, and to the uttermost part. You received it because I received it. I gave you. You should spread it. That is the spirit of leadership. And so this morning, I want to ask that we obey that injunction, that instruction, that inspiration that Jesus gave to his disciples, that once you receive power, don't sit on it. Don't sit with it. Don't watch it. Use it, act on it. And so today I want to just ask that you lead with a flow. Somebody said, lead with a flow. Oh, say it loud. I say, lead with a flow. Say, can you, I know the weather is cool, but the energy you use is not from the weather. You are the one that will impose the energy. Can you say loud? I say, lead with a flow. So I'll be reading 2 Corinthians chapter 2. I'll read verses 14 and 15. Now, thanks be to God, who always, please say with me, always. Can we spell it together? Can we spell it? That is, amen, amen, amen. You know what just happened? We act on assumption. You assumed I was going to repeat the same thing. You will not be confused in Jesus' name. So now, can we spell always together? A-L-W-A-Y-S. It's important. I think the last abbreviation is the way my wife used to, refer to herself, A-Y-S, okay? Okay, so basically, what I want us to see is that what you're about to read must register with you on the expectation that we should have when we deal with God or when we draw from God. I say that again. You should have a particular expectation when you deal with God and when you draw from God. So it shows us something, the attitude with which we should continue in our dealings with him. So I'm going to crave your indulgence, let's read this together. 2 Corinthians 2, we read verses 14 and 15. Again, once ago. Now, thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumph in Christ, and through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place. For we are to God the fragrance of Christ among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. My prayer for someone here is that you will experience new results. You will tell new stories of success. Where you have not testified in a long time, you'll have something new to say about grace in the name of Jesus Christ. God will refresh your memory of how you started with him. And he will put something in your hand that you've been expecting. In Jesus' name. I want us to quickly look at that 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. And I'll just highlight some points for us to see why I'm suggesting or inspiring that you lead with a flow. So it says here, anytime God wants to do this thing he wants to do, it is continuous, it is consistent. It always does that. My prayer is that you will always experience good from God in the name of Jesus Christ. And what is the thing? It says, is to live a victorious life. It leads us. It directs us. It inspires us. It influences us. You see leading there. It's the same way we say we're a leader. So God leads us. He's not just telling us. He influences us. How does he influence you? Give you the anointing, give you ideas, lead you to those that will show you favor, excite you, inspire you, awaken you. When you feel lazy, you don't want to fulfill your purpose, sometimes he just makes sure that he comforts you by bringing what will enable you to, you know, make progress. And sometimes, if you are not slow, it creates problems. Go and ask Jonah. When Jonah did not want to fulfill his purpose, to go and influence the people of Nineveh, he just created a storm. By the time they threw Jonah into the whale, he woke up. Someone here, my prayer is that you will not learn by wisdom. But to understand, Jesus learned obedience by the things he suffered. So your response to God, and will I say your the quickness, the promptness of your response to God may determine the force it releases to you. He says, to the pure, I'll be pure. What it means, your attitude towards God will determine the way he releases his energy towards you. If you are disobedient, you may be like Jonah. Amen? Why? So you don't miss it. Everything God did for Jonah was to ensure he does not miss his purpose. I feel like praying for someone here. In your old age, you will not regret. Let's say that to you again. When you want to retire, you will not retire tired in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not feel like life drained you in the name of Jesus Christ. So when God begins to give us course correction, directing us, leading us in the ways to triumph, even if it is grievous, but his commandments are not grievous, if it is not convenient, you should remember, the covenant is superior to convenience. Hello, somebody. Always remember, once you are in covenant, whether it is good or bad, we will obey the voice of the Lord. Once he instructs, you do. So he always leads us, influences us. Whether it's good influence or painful one, he influences us. Jesus did not want to go to the cross. But because the Father said so, he says in Matthew chapter 26, if it is your will, if it is your will, he submitted to the will of Father. That is God leading him to triumph. At the end of the day, look at how we celebrate him all over the world. If God did not lead him to triumph, as had accepted Jesus' proposal in the flesh, you and I will not be sitting in church. I'm sure you agree. So sometimes, God has to prepare you, and I'm suggesting to someone here, if you don't adjust your mind to the flow that God has orchestrated for you, you may be looking for pain as part of your preparation. But it doesn't have to be. May God give us wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. But see the consistency in the way God expects us to triumph. He always leads us to triumph, and he gives us the root of that triumph in Christ. Please help me in Christ. You can't win with God If you remove Christ out of the equation of your life, anything outside Christ is crisis. You only win if you are in Christ. In Him we live. In Him we move. In Him we consist. It's like saying, you want to succeed living outside the globe, outside the half. Who will give you oxygen? Everything you need is where God has placed you and planted you. Any tree that does not take roots will not last. Hello, somebody here. I believe that God is bringing us the spirit of wisdom. You will not lose your place in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to see the flow again in that 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. And he says, so once he does that in Christ, he now through us. Please say with me, through us. Now you see the way this discourse is going. First, God gives you what you want. Then he ensures that other people get what they want through what he gave you. It leads you to triumph. You are excited giving testimonies, promotion, business expansion. But who is benefiting from the wisdom you drew to do it? It now says, through us. Please help me again, through us. It now diffuses the knowledge. It makes sure that what you are doing and doing well, other people now know how to do. It spreads. It says, it's like a fragrance. Once someone enters a place and the fragrance is strong, like Mary did in Mark chapter 14 when she brought the fragrant oil. Wherever you start, it is nowhere it ends. By itself, it spreads. God is a spirit. So he uses a physical material, fragrance, to let us know our attitude. So he says, through us, it diffuses through us the fragrance of his knowledge. And I love the way it ends it. In every place. It's saying here, your influence, your spread of leadership, the way you take out the spirit of leadership, because that's fragrance, spirit moves. Any spirit will spread. Even demons spread. They enter, they come out. Okay. Let it be that everywhere, in your home, in your office, in the marketplace, anyone that comes in contact with you, like Jesus says, I am the way. The person comes in contact with you, then comes into leadership, begins to think and act as a leader, and comes to the knowledge of your own source of the spirit of leadership in Christ. Is that clear? I'm not saying essence here. Anywhere you go, let people feel you. Like I once said to a group of people, I feel it's an insult on my destiny if I stay in a place and I leave, they don't remember I came. You did not release the fragrance. The moment they were eating at the table in Mark 14, when Mary entered and broke the flask of fragrant oil, the discussion changed direction. They focused on her. She did not say a word. See, anywhere you are, things are not right. If you don't react, you're irresponsible. Can I say that again? Anywhere you are, and you cooperate with mediocrity, you are killing the vision of the place. Anything you do, if somebody writes a letter for you and the letter is not good, thank you, you should not accept or sign it. If the person will resign, do not sign. Hello, somebody here. Somebody is asking you to lie with a proposal. Don't be part of evil, because the cup of the Amorites will come to fullness in one day. I have said many things now. Amen. God will give you wisdom to protect your future. You will always have people who will want you to bend the rules. If you bend it, you will break it. So don't bend it. God upholds all things by the word of his power. Upholds means once you want to push it down, you will pull it up. And that's what causes contention. You may have a challenge with your boss in the office. Why? He sets the standard. You want to succeed without a standard, there will be a contention. He upholds all things by the word of his power. If you don't have personal power, obstructions will stop you easily. And that is where the understanding of dominion comes in. God says to us in Genesis 1:28, be fruitful. And he says, I have dominion. What's dominion? Dominion means you have energy. You are intense and it keeps flowing through you. Dominion is intense energy, which means your personal power are very deep and nothing can stop it from flowing. Am I making sense to somebody else? So in life, let's learn the rules that ensure our influence does not stop. Why is it that the sun has not been able to be covered by the clouds without shining through? Hello, somebody here. Think about it. Why is it that when the sun is supposed to come up, the clouds may become dark, but somehow you will see there's light? Whatever tries to veil you and shield you, fight it. Shall I say that to you again? Whatever tries to veil, confuse you, cover your vision, cover your eyes, fight. Some people have lost their fighting spirit, forgetting, he says, it will teach your hands to war. God is a man of war. Hello, somebody here. Am I making sense here? So you must enforce your ideas, your vision, your understanding of what you should be doing, enforce it with energy, with intensity, with life. That is dominion. Hello, somebody here. I said something earlier. That mandate of dominion was given before man was made. Genesis 1:26, it said, let us make man. It was a proposal in the spirit form. Genesis 1:28, God made man and blessed him. That was the spirit form of man. Genesis 2:7, God formed man out of the dust and breathed into him. Then let the action start. You know what I'm saying here? Influence, intensity, energy, dominion is in your spirit. It was there before we were born. All we do is to fan it to flame. I lay before you death and life. Choose one. Don't choose sleep over spirit. When men slept, the enemy came, changed the vision of their lives. He planted tares in the place of wheat. When you are sleeping too much, you'll be confused when you wake up. Because the wheat and the tares, they look alike. If you have not been reading your Bible, you don't even understand what I'm saying. Paul says, before I come, give attention to reading. So sometimes the message is a waste. Why? You did not prepare your heart to receive it. Matthew 13, the parable of the sower. And that's why I suggest, please, make sure that you always get messages. They are free. On YouTube, subscribe. We have a WhatsApp group where every service is sent there. The link is sent there. You can watch it on our website and all of that. So that the day the Holy Spirit awakens you, there's always a season of awakening, you will know where to get more content to maintain your flow. Praise the Lord. God started the world, what we call nature, with movement, with activity, with the flow. The spirit moved. Why am I saying that again? We have the responsibility to draw the energy, to draw the life, to use it. When the spirit moved, God spoke, he used the energy. Speaking means you start the ideas God has planted in your heart for so long. You go into action. You begin to have a flow. A flow is a sign of life. It means nothing is dormant. Anywhere there are no activities, things are dead. So a flow is to bring you back to a point where even if something dies inside, you wake it up. That is dominion. Why? There must be continuity. So that principle of flow, of activity, of energy, of release of what is in you into what is in the environment was started before the impartation of influence or dominion. Which means whatever wants to stop the flow, you will draw from the deposit inside you to remove it and ensure the flow. That's why Mary had the flask of oil in Mark chapter 14. She broke it so that the fragrance can come out. You need to fight so that the faith in you can catch fire. Hello, somebody here. You cannot cooperate with your own weakness. Don't do that. A little sleep, a little slumber. You will think you are sleeping, but hear me, people of God, something is coming. It says your poverty comes. As you are sleeping, you are inviting something. The only problem is, trees don't wither overnight and they confuse us. The fact that failure is not overnight is a problem. You know, if they sack immediately without expectations, you will react. But when they keep warning you and writing queries, you don't react. But the sack has started. Hello, somebody here. Parable of talents, Matthew 25. A master gave three associate talents, 5, 3, and 1. The man with one, because the master went for a long time, he was sleeping, he was abusing the master behind. The man reaps where he does not sow. He did not know that all that complaint, rather than work, you are complaining. Rather than network and connect and market, you are complaining. Because when the master came, he said, why didn't you take what belongs to me to the bankers? You know what he's saying? The energy you use to gist and abuse, why don't you use it to improve your life? Why don't you go to a banker and be gisting about investment rather than gisting about abusing your boss? It's the same energy, isn't it? It's not the same talk. You will do the same talk, talk the same thing. The only thing is, one is wasteful, one is productive. I don't know why I'm saying all of this today. You will see that no slide has scrolled. Why? It's not in the slide. Anything God inspires on the spur of the moment is more needed than your preparation. Hello, somebody here. So let's go further with this. Please say with me again, lead with the flow. Oh, say it again, say lead with the flow. Lead with the flow. I say, please say with me again, say lead with a flow. I'll read Revelation chapter 3, verses 15 and 16. God says here, I know your works, that you are neither cold nor hot. I could wish you were cold or hot. But then, because you are lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will vomit you out of my mouth. You know what God is saying? If you want life to be progressive, you should be consistent. You should decide if your intensity will keep flowing or if you want to cooperate neglecting your responsibilities. I try not to say it in a bad way. Okay? You understand what I'm saying? What I'm saying is you have to make sure that life, energy, whatever will show that your mind is present activity, you must ensure that they come out of you, through you. There must be sign. What is coma or a state of stupor? Somebody is alive in spirit, but dead in real life. You know, coma means you touch the person is not responding, but the person is breathing. But the person, can the person go to work? Hello, somebody. Can the person go to work? Can the person earn salary? So we are like that. We are thinking and thinking and thinking, but we are not doing. You know these things. Blessed are you if you know them. Hello, somebody here. So you have to show everywhere you are that you are active, that there's something flowing through you to those around you so that they can recognize you and reward you. If I don't feel you, I don't remember you. Can I say something to someone here? You must be consistent if you want life to cooperate with you. Have you noticed businesses that you come today, They open today, they don't open tomorrow. And the day you have an emergency, you rush to the shop, it's not open. Next time you want to buy something and you are away from home, will you not buy your thing from outside? Why? Unreliability. If you want life to cooperate with you, be consistent. From the first day that the Holy Ghost moved, he has not withdrawn his presence. We still have the Holy Ghost here. From the beginning that the Spirit of the Lord moved, in the Old Testament, when the New Testament started, it was relevant. Some people, when they restructured their company, they are not relevant. When God restructured and changed the basis of the covenant from the Abrahamic covenant to grace, some people lost. How can it be that because the market is changing, you have forgotten? What it means is that you are not making yourself relevant. If you have been flowing consistently, you will flow with the change. I beg of you, when you end this session, take this message, listen properly. You will hear some of the things you missed. We love the Holy Spirit, but it's always consistent.
Amen.